So I'm Dr. Duncan Forgan. I'm an astrophysicist slash astrobiologist, and I work at the University of St. Andrews. So SETI stands for the Search for Extraterrestrial Intelligence, and it's concerned with trying to find signs of intelligent life off the Earth, so on another planet, going around another star somewhere in the Milky Way. Well, the Milky Way is a really big place. There are a lot of stars. We think there's about 100 billion stars, and it looks like from our studies of exoplanets, so planets outside the solar system, we think that more or less every single one of those stars has planets. So that's a lot of planets, and we've only searched a small fraction of them, and we're really only just starting this kind of journey to learn not just about the planets, but about the atmospheres of the planets and whether those planets could be suitable for life. And then at the very end, could they be suitable for life like us that builds technology, which is the thing that SETI looks for. I'm a bit of a pessimist. I don't think we're going to find alien civilizations that look like us and are still here. I think what we might find is that we find alien civilizations that look nothing like us and are not here, in the sense that they used to be here and something has happened and they've died out. Now, you might think, well, what's the point of doing this if you don't expect to find anything? But there's an important thing you have to learn as a scientist, is that you can have an opinion, but first you make that opinion, you make a hypothesis perhaps, and then you test that hypothesis by going and looking. So even if you're not convinced you're going to find anything, as a scientist you have to prove that your hunch is correct by going out there and actually searching. That's a really good question. Now, it's going to be very tough to find it by looking at it from Earth, because Europa is a moon of Jupiter. It's very icy. It's got a very thick icy crust. And we know from measurements of how its gravity changes when probes go around it that there's liquid water under the surface. Now, to really find out whether there's life in that ocean underneath the ice, we actually have to go there and land something on it, drill through the ice, and essentially put a submarine into that ocean. That's the only way we're going to really know for sure. And that's very expensive. And it also requires a nuclear powered drill, which is going to be quite a challenging thing to put on another planet or another moon. Perhaps in 10, 20 years' time, if we have the money and politicians are happy with the idea, maybe this is something we could do. Well, the next big thing in our field of research really is going to be finding planets like the Earth. Now, when you look at the newspaper, you might see an article saying, "Most Earth-like planet found." Now, what that headline really says is, this planet still isn't Earth-like. Because what they're really saying is that we found a planet that's a little bit smaller than we've been finding before, still not the same size as the Earth. Or we've been finding a planet that's still quite massive, not as low mass as the Earth. And even if you find a planet that has the same mass and the same radius as the Earth, that doesn't guarantee that it's Earth-like. Earth has a lot of properties that go beyond its mass and its radius. It has to be going around the right kind of star at the right kind of distance. It's got to have the right kind of chemicals and molecules in its atmosphere. It has to have the right magnetic field to shield it from all that harmful radiation that we can get from the sun. It may need to have a moon for us to really think about it as Earth-like. And the moon is quite a big satellite compared to the size of the Earth. So all these things really might have to go into our definition of what really is an Earth. So the next big thing will be finding planets that we think really are habitable. We're not quite there yet, but we're getting very, very close. So that will be the next big thing.
An atom could be in several places at the same time. It can sort of be here and it can also be there. It's not either or, it's not here or there.